So let's look at another place that hash values are used all over, and that's Git. So some of you are new to Git. Others of you have maybe had some more experience with this. So Git is a version control system. And what it's trying to do is make sure that every time you commit something, you always have that information around whenever you need it in the future. And Git uses hashes all over the place. And once you start to notice them, you'll see them sort of hiding in plain sight. Okay, so this is the CS125 GitHub page. And I'm gonna go into kind of like one of the projects that we maintain. This is actually the source code for the auto grader for the class. And you'll see, this thing? This is a hash, and it's actually just the beginning of a hash. It's the first 8 characters of a longer hash value. Let's click on that and see what happens. Okay, so now over here, you see this thing on the right? This is a hash code. It's the hash code for the commit. Now, this is a little complicated. When you commit something, Git actually produces a hash for the entire commit, which includes the contents of your all the files in your directory at the time, and then the message that you add, and all the sort of information. But internally, Git uses commits for hash values for everything. It uses them for commits, uses them to compare the contents of files to each other. So when you push your code to GitHub, for example, one of the things that happens is that when you do that is that your computer communicates with GitHub. And one of the ways that they exchange information is they exchange hashes. So your computer will say, hey, I've got these files, and it sends GitHub a bunch of hashes. And GitHub will say, okay, well, I've already got a lot of those files, because it uses the hashes to compare the files. You don't send the whole file every time, you send a hash. Then GitHub says, oh, hold on a sec, I see I'm missing a few files that you have that are new, why don't you send me those? And so that's why, you know, every time you push, you don't transfer all the contents of everything in your repository. That would be extremely inefficient. You just send that one file of the little pieces that GitHub needs. So again, once you start noticing these, you know, you see them all over the place. Here's the parent commit. In particular, Git uses hashes to represent commits. But again, Git really uses hashes to represent every single type of object that it maintains in your repository. That includes the file content, that includes, you know, all other pieces of information, right? Now, we're gonna talk in a minute about hash collisions, which means that two files hash to the same value. And one of the things that's important to Git is that this never, ever, ever, ever happens. Like, Git would just melt down if it ever encountered this situation. Git's entire approach is predicated on this idea that if the hash values for two files are the same, the file contents are identical. If I have two files that have identical, different contents, it would hash to the same value, this would produce a big problem for Git. So that's just something to keep in mind. That's one of the reasons why these values are so big. So if you look at this, this is actually a number. It's expressed in what's called hexadecimal, where we use 0 through 9, and then you also see the letters A through F, that are used to represent 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. So this is a base 16 numbering system. Anyway, this just happens to be a really big number. The reason why it's so big is that it has to be big enough to reduce the probability that there are collisions to a tiny, 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 tiny level. Now, could there be a collision? Yeah, I mean, it's not zero. But if there is, you'll probably read about it, like in the news or in the tech news or something. I mean, this is something that people would talk about, you know, the day that somebody broke Git because they actually introduced a hash collision into a project which Git wasn't expecting. So far, I haven't heard about that happening. Obviously, it could happen in the future. One of the things that Git has done over the years, though, is it has started to use bigger and bigger hashes to reduce the probability of collisions even further. But anyway, so this is another use of hashes, right? And really, in any sort of content fingerprinting system, right? What Git wants to do is it wants to make sure that has a compact way to store a fingerprint. Now, keep in mind, the hash is not a compressed version of the file. There's no way to take this value and reconstruct the contents of the file. It's a one-way function. You take the file contents and you get this hash out. You can't take the hash and go back in the other direction. But the idea is that if two hash functions are different, then the two files are supposed to be different. If the two hash functions are the same, then the two files had better be identical.